Hey, it's your buddy Tim Schull with another Raid Shadow Legends video. And this video, as you guessed by the thumbnail, is a video about gear sets. The video is going to be targeted towards folks like myself who have a player power between 1 million and probably 5 million. You know, late early game to mid game, maybe even a little later mid game, folks like me who are struggling with progression, either in Faction Wars or Doom Tower, maybe even not being able to complete all the dungeons. And I wanted to get into how sets work and the set I think everyone needs to make their base set and build from there. You probably already know, but every set that Plarium offers you is made up of components that all have the same stats, right? So you can get the same attack, crit damage, accuracy, attack percentage on an offensive set as you can on a life set, as you can on a crit rate set, as you can on a crit damage set. Now, not all stats are created equal. Plarium hands out some stats in just whopping goops, handing out with a fire hose. So crit damage, attack percentage, defensive percentage, AP percentage, even the flat stats are just really, really big numbers. And then other stats they give out in a more measured approach, like accuracy, where you can get, you know, pretty decent accuracy numbers with the sets, adding 40 accuracy for every two, and then you get a nice great haul bonus. You can build up accuracy on the line items for each set, and then obviously a pretty good accuracy number on your banner. So you can get, you know, close to 100 accuracy. So accuracy is not such an issue, but there is one stat that Plarium hands out with a teaspoon and an eyedropper. A stat that they just do not want you to be able to get at too easily, which makes me think that that's the stat we want to have, because that's the stat that's going to make the most impact in the game. And I'm guessing that you know that I'm talking about speed. Speed is a stat that they give out very unwillingly. Build two artifacts per set of the speed, and you get 12% on your base speed. So if your base speed is 100, you're going to get 12%. So a total of 36, right? Which is sort of an average roll to start with a flat stat. But for speed, that's the most they're going to give you. You know, the regular rolls on speed also are super low. Like the highest you can get on a regular speed roll is 7, and that doesn't really even happen that much. I'm more used to seeing 4s and 5s, and you see a 6, you feel pretty good about it. You see a 7, boy, you're loving life. So the idea is we want to be building as much speed as possible and then loading in all the stats we need for each champion. Now, obviously, I'm not talking about your go last champions, your nukers, or your guys that are doing some job last, which I can't think of anyone but a nuker. But all of your debuffers, your crowd control champions, your buff champions all need to go just as fast as possible, especially through the mid game to try to beat some of these mobs. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show a couple examples, and then we're going to sort of build one. We're going to start with my Mashaled, who is in a pretty good set, lifesteal set, and show him in some content struggling, and then we will book him out in a speed set and show that he is much better with maybe losing some of his attack stats, but gaining his speed. Now, here's a good example of what I'm talking about. So I have my campaign farmer is a bellower. Now, I was never able to get super great stats on my bellower, but what I could do is I could get him a bunch of speed. So if we look at his total stats, you'll see he doesn't have wonderful stats, right? But what he does have is twice the speed of the mobs he's facing. So he's going to get two turns before that last wave of mobs even gets a turn. As you can see here, as I go through this content, he's going to wipe out first and the second wave pretty easily, but the third wave sticks around. Now, if he didn't have the speed he had, that third wave would nuke him and he would be done. So first wave down, second wave down, third wave, boom, didn't kill them all, but he gets to go again, and that's the end of him. So I get an 8-second run with a bellower who is easy to build and is sort of the budget campaign farmer, which is really good. We're going to look at my Mashaled, and then I will come back with a different build, and we can talk about how that all works. So here's my Mashaled, built out very nicely in a lifesteal set. If you have a Mashaled, congratulations. I think he's probably one of the best champs in the game. I mean, he is just self-sustaining, hits hard, does all the things you want a big nuking champ to do. So you can see I have him built out with, you know, low HP, as high, about as high attack as I can get on him. Low damage, you know, decent speed, not quite the crit rate I want, but some decent crit damage, and then enough accuracy to land his fears. Let me show you sort of a campaign. He can solo a lot of the nightmare stuff, but on this one, I have about a 50% success rate running him through this. So it's right on the edge of what he can do. I hope actually he fails on this, so when we come back with his new set, he can come through and make it happen. So you can see he just is constantly putting out those fears and leeches and healing himself and just being a complete menace. I think anybody that's ever had to face this guy in arena knows that it is super frustrating, and you're like, how often does he get that fear up? I mean, it is just hard to deal with. So we're gonna let him run through this, and hopefully he dies, and then we'll come back in a speed set where I'm gonna build him just as fast as I can with some defense and HP. And while he's not gonna do the same sexy damage on each ability, he is going to last a lot longer and fly through the content. So we will see you in a minute. Okay, so we are back, and we have built out our Mashalet in three speed sets. We bumped up his HP, lost a bunch of attack, got some better defense, got his speed way, way up there, kept his crit rate, and kept his accuracy so we continue to hit those fears, because that's gonna be super important. So let's go to the content. So Nightmare, 8-3, Mashalet at 219 speed. Let's see if we can get her done. So you can see he's hitting fears, going twice. Healing up, so they can't go. So you can see his numbers aren't as sexy as they were when I had him in the lifesteal, but he just is going and going and going, and the fears are being placed, and again, that's a tough thing to beat. So yeah, let's see. The second wave is usually the problem. On these mobs, these abysses but they hit hard. So if we can live through this, I think we'll be okay. Okay, I think we're gonna do it. Let's attack her until they stop with their nonsense counterattacks. You can see much tankier, you know, giving up some of the attack sets and allowing him just to go over and over again and take advantage of his continuous heals and fears is going to actually make this run very, very easy. So we'll let this finish, and then we will talk about a few other things, and then we'll wrap up this video. So. Actually, I might try him in arena as well. I don't know. I know facing some of these guys is tough, but he might be going fast. I'm not sure he's fast enough for my arena team, but we'll see. We'll give it a shot, and if I don't attach that video, it means it didn't go like I hoped. Actually, I'll attach it anyway. We'll take a look at it together. But you can see, adding speed and giving up some of the offensive stats made that run very, very easy. So let's take him to the arena. As you can see, I'm kind of mid gold four. I don't really have an issue staying in gold four. Pretty good teams. I use a Blender comp, and then I have a Trunda team that I use if their team is super tanky. Let's put Mashalet in here and see how he goes. And give my theory on how to do an arena team, what to look for, so you're not fighting teams that are just wiping you and wasting arena tokens. So let's see how this goes. We're gonna swap him for Trunda and see if he can just keep those fears up and keep stuff going on these guys. So let's see. Okay, fears are up, she's dead. No one's gonna be able to do anything because the Mashalet has got them all feared. Oh, that hurts. Frozen the Ray with the freeze, but I put enough tanky stats on him. He's Hopefully it'll live. Fears are up again. Continuous heal. Nukes them down. So you can see, and again, I don't have any glyphs on him or anything. Just took him right into Gold 4 Arena. No speed tuning. And he did fine. Took a couple of hits. Got a couple of turns off. And lead and damage. This is my final thoughts on the video and things I'd like you to remember. Remember the number 176. 176 is the speed number you will hit if you have 3 speed sets and 5-star speed boots in your speed set. It's 181 if you have 6-star speed boots. So that's a big number. That's without any speed substats. So you can get speed substats on your banner and then obviously on any of the other items. Here's Martyr. Martyr is someone I'm going to be building. I just pulled her, so I'm very excited. I'm going to do a champion spotlight on her. And I'm going to build her in all speed sets with all defense. Just massive defense, massive speed. Just let her do all those terrible counterattacks. My advice, if you're, you know, where I am, is to farm Dragon. Just farm Dragon. Get as much speed gear as you can to go through it. I know that if you're like me, you recognize it takes hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of pieces of gear to cycle through to find that 2 or 3 pieces that actually get the rolls you wanted and get the rolls after the original rolls that you wanted as well. So take advantage of Dragon. You get, I think, 2 of the best sets there, which are the speed and the lifesteal. And then once you start to edge towards late mid game and maybe early late game, is you can start to pull off speed sets and put on some of those really sexy sets, right? The cruel sets and the savage sets and then the immunities and things like that, where you actually have enough of those items to find the ones that are going to keep your speed high enough and all your stats high enough. So again, Tim Shell, your buddy, your mid-game Avenger, and please subscribe, like the video, leave me comments. I'd love to hear from you. We'll see you next time. Thanks.